Hi, I'm Chris with Residio, and I'm here to share with you a few tech tips to help you when you're using Universal RTS products. Today's tech tip will focus on the S8610 Universal Intermittent Pilot Ignition Controller, one of my favorites. A common call our tech support team receives regarding the S8610 happens when, during a call for heat, the pilot lights, but the spark doesn't stop, and then the main valve doesn't open to light that main burner. Or in some cases, the spark does stop after the pilot is lit, but the main valve still does not open to light the main burner. This happens during the 90-second trial for ignition. After the trial for ignition, the S8610 will go into a 5-minute delay or lockout. Then the S8610 will try this process all over again, and you'll just end up with the same results. These symptoms are typical of a flame rectification or flame proving issue. What is flame rectification, you ask? Flame rectification occurs by detecting a small amount of current passing through the pilot flame. The S8610 will measure that current, which proves the pilot flame is present. The sequence of operation goes a little bit like this. When the S8610 receives the call for heat from the thermostat, the pilot valve will open and the pilot burner will begin to spark. Once the pilot flame is lit, there is a very small amount of DC current, about 2 microamps, that is detected by the S8610. The presence of this pilot flame is now proven, and the main valve is allowed to open and to light the main burner. So when the pilot lights and the spark doesn't stop and the main valve does not open to light that main burner, or maybe the pilot does light and the spark does stop, but the main burner valve still doesn't open to light the main burner, then that tells you the flame signal isn't getting back to the S8610. There are a few causes to look at for this issue. This could be due to a dirty or weak pilot flame. So take a good look at the pilot flame. If it is burning mostly yellow, it's considered weak. It should be mostly blue with a little yellow towards the tip. If it is weak, inspect the pilot burner and clean the orifice, or more easily just replace the entire pilot burner. It is also possible the flame rod is out of position or dirty. To make sure this isn't the problem, check the flame rod for the correct position, and if it appears to be dirty, clean it up with a very light abrasive. Some techs I know just use a dollar bill they have in their pocket to clean it up. Also inspect the sparking cable. Make sure it isn't cut or frayed, allowing the spark to jump through the insulation to anywhere else on the unit. And don't forget to inspect the porcelain on the sparker to make sure it isn't cracked and sparking through to ground. Lastly, one of the most common reasons for this is because the ground wire from the S86 burner ground terminal to the pilot burner is not making a good connection, or it is being affected by multiple grounds from the pilot burner to the chassis or another place on the equipment, like the gas valve, for example. It's not uncommon to see multiple ground wires from the pilot burner to the chassis, but it really isn't necessary. The pilot burner should be mounted to a clean mating surface, which is grounding back to the chassis through its mount. When multiple ground wires at the pilot burner are present, the measurable current can drop, and there may not be enough current getting back to the S8610 to detect the pilot flame. Therefore, the S8610 won't open the main valve. Just be sure you have a good connection to your ground wires from the main burner ground terminal on the S8610 to the pilot burner, and that it isn't broken or frayed.